The Card Wildlife Education Center is basically a museum with animals or taxidermy of animals from all around the world. It exists because of a gentleman named Roger Card who had a fascination with wildlife and who was also a Ferris alumni, and he found it appropriate to donate all his specimens to the university to share his love for animals with everyone that comes to visit the center.
Almost everything in here was actually taken by Roger and Deborah Card. And they were concerned about educating people, about showing them the wildlife of the world.
Here, there's over 200 animals and $1 million in taxidermy.
These animals, most of them, have more value to the locals as animals to be hunted, because the poacher is not going to pay them anything if they kill that animal. So the locals won't make any money at all. But if a hunter comes in, the hunter pays for guides, the hunter pays for the meat processing, the hunter pays for everything, and the tribe gets the meat. My passion is bringing students, children, parents, adults through here and talking about why they're here and how they can get involved with the environment. You don't have to be a hunter, but you should understand where these things come from.
The experience that we provide to our visitors. A lot of people don't get the chance to see all these specimens ever. And so when they come here, they get to see animals from all over the world.
I definitely enjoy people's reactions when they come in here and see Deborah Card's world record moose.
It's also a really educational experience, and it's really cool to look at all these animals too. There's lots to learn, and Even if you don't want to learn anything, there's lots to look at, and it's great for all ages too, for older people who like to learn stuff, for little kids who like to explore all the great animals. It's just a good experience overall.
One of the outreach programs that we participate in is we actually go to the schools and we take several of our exhibits with us, and we'll have a couple of the staff members go along and they discuss some of the animal facts that we would discuss while if they were to come to the museum. We usually have some kind of hands-on activity. We take the hands-on furs.
Giving tours, sometimes you'll give a fact about something that somebody didn't know, and then you can just see the expression on their face.
My favorite age group is probably elementary, because they're just so excited to be here already.
For the preschoolers, it's a lot easier if you relate to them stuff that they already know. If they can answer a question, they feel a lot smarter versus if you just tell them a lot of information. So when I'm giving a tour for younger kids, I like to ask them a lot of questions and relate to stuff that they know what the animals are talking about. A lot of stuff they have no idea because they've just been in school for a year. And
you can't really get into specific biological details with the young ones, but there are things that you can incorporate that are fun for them and educational as well.
The hippopotamus, for example, is the most deadly animal in Africa. We have an animal over here called the Gemsbuck. It has very long, long horns on it. And those horns, up until mid-1800s, were more valuable than gold because they were sold as unicorn horns.
I love it when, at the end of tours, you ask a question and the kids get it. They understand. It just makes me know that after I've done the tour, they were following along and they understood what I was talking about.
I like to be able to give tours to students and watch them actually be interested in something. I think that that doesn't happen a lot of the time in the normal classroom, and being able to supply that to them is pretty rewarding.